course, because she's, you know,
so, you're working on making your writing into 2 stars?
Yeah.
So what did you do? So show me what work you've done.
Just from the Friday.
Okay. All right. So
me. Oh wait, hold on.
So talk to me about this.
That's me. Okay. And if you want to know my characteristics of me, there you go.
Okay. So my question for you.
I don't really have a bendy ending machine chair. I didn't know how to make a finished furniture, so this is trying to go with bendy ending machine.
Okay. So when you look at this progression.
Also that's my cat's escape.
Alright, so looking here, this is about noticing story elements. Right, it's a 2-star.
It's a carrot. And Ted, the
are you the character?
No, Ralph is, and there's a.
So you have about you, right? Is this you too?
No, that's Ralph. I tried making the cover on the. Is that?
What day is that? It doesn't matter. So, looking at this. Okay, you have your character. What did you say here? Talk to me about what you have here.
Characteristics. He has a dog walking business called Chief Walks Inc.
Okay, what else do you notice?
Has a lot of problems has a lot of trouble in his on his hands, and he makes comics for fun.
Okay. So when I look at this, and you're looking at your character here, what did you do? What did you do here?
I did the characteristics.
You noticed some things about the character, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So definitely. Now, if I go to this page, this is more about you, right?
And also Raph.
So what were you doing here?
I said same thing on the back page, which is actually this, so I kept on drawing arrows to here.
Okay.
See, it says here.
Okay.
And it said, cool comic maker dog walker. Guess if you can tell right here, there's the dog.
So what I kind of see, I kind of think you were trying to do, and
wait,
I don't know if you were doing this.
I should write a speech bubble saying wolf.
Okay, so what I think you were trying to do, were you trying to do some comparing yourself to the character?
Yeah. I'll say like a 1.5 star.
Okay. So you were trying to do some of that work.
2.5. 2.5.
Here's what I think. Can I teach you something?
No.
I want you to do this kind of work, but I want you to do it even more by doing some thinking about comparing maybe not just you to the character, but maybe could you compare the character to another character, you know, like in another book? No? Have you read any books like this or like that have characters like this?
Yeah, there's one book that has a crossover of this book and that book in my cubby.
Okay.
It was actually in that book. It had Raph in it and the Jimmy.
Okay.
Jimmy Wong.
So the other thing is that you could compare.
Wait a second. I need to check out both of their last names real quick.
I think you're going there. You just need to get his attention.
Yeah.
You can be firm with
them. Nope, not the same.
Okay.
Not the same blood.
All right. So.
I like where you're going.
So, you have this character, right? Sit down. Sit down on your seat.
So, pardon me. Okay. You're going to grow as a reader is if you listen to Miss Wren's tips. Okay. She's going to give you tips so you can try out and grow on this progression next time. So, listen.
Okay.
Don't talk. Just listen for a few minutes.
Okay. You can compare this character to a character you know. You can also compare your character to another element in the text. So you
like
could,
me.
Go for it. What are you thinking?
Like me. I compare it to me.
You're not a character in the story, though.
So it can't be you.
You can't be you. So you can compare it to the setting. Like compare the character to the setting to see how are those influencing each other. Or maybe how are they alike. You can do that. You can think about, I don't know, the plot and compare this plot to another plot. You're right. What are you thinking? What comes to your mind when you think about, I haven't read this book, so I don't know him. What kind of work could you do that compares something? Because I like that you were doing that work and thinking about comparing. What do you think? Now, I know you know Keck. Could you?
Wrath. His name's Wrath.
No, in The Home of the Brave. Read aloud.
Keck.
Could you compare Keck to him? Are there any similarities between them? Or differences that you could think about?
Show me the cover of Keck.
Home of the Brave. I don't have the book in my hand right now, but the one with the cow on the front.
And him.
You could.
Because I need to see the differences.
Sticky note. You could make a T-chart.
I don't know how to make a T-chart.
So you could do, here's Keck, and then here's Rash, is his name?
It's R-A-F-E.
Okay, so you could think about doing a T-chart, okay, to compare those two. See that book? Okay. I'm gonna let you think about that. I'm gonna leave you away. Leave you to get to some work.
There's no difference. They're not really the same, but they're.
Okay, so why don't you think? Can open the book and think about what's in here and what they're talking about, like what characteristics about the character, not just what they look like, but how they act or where they're at.
It would turn into yellow. Oh, that's messed up.
Okay, so what do you think you could do? Do you think you can get some thinking down about comparing these two together and seeing what you can find and look inside the text?
Like, maybe you could think about their hopes.
I'm so
hard. Maybe you could think about their challenges. And you can do this kind of work with all books. It doesn't just have to be Home of the Brave and middle school.
Middle school, the dog's best friend. Also, maybe I can search out the book.
No, he's doing. No, you don't need to do that. You can just look right here.
But search out the book series. This is book 8. This is book 8. And there's a lot more books about it.
Right, but you don't have
I can
that.
Like search up.
But you don't have it with you right this second. So we want you to do this work with some books that you do have.
Charlins, we're going to come back in a little bit, and you need to have some of that work done.
All right, now.